just going to be back here saying amen to you. Some folk can't get excited till it's their turn. Can't have church till they get the mic. Can't praise God till they in front. Oh, God, I'm trying to help preachers. Every preacher ought to get with a preacher that's preaching truth, because you're going to be up here. And it's lonely out here when ain't nobody helping you. At least your colleagues in arms ought to be able to identify with the struggle you're dealing with. Because when you're trying to preach, all kind of thoughts from the devil is trying to get in your mind, trying to confuse your thought processes. But I know God will make a way somehow. Let me move on and get into the text here. We are dealing with a situation in Scripture. Here John the Baptist understood at an early age his role. He understood. That's amazing about John, because he was fascinating. This man had the Holy Ghost before he got born. Now we all got it being born again, but he got it before he was born. This man was not a brother. He was Jesus' cousin. He was older than Jesus. Yet he said, it ain't about me. He was so bad that this man could preach and tell the gospel truth. He didn't tell them they was going to ride in a new car. He didn't tell them money cometh. He didn't tell them all your troubles. Oh, he said, you've been lying. You killed the prophets. You vipers. Your parents was no good. And folk came by the foul. I just say, if we start preaching, and see, that's the problem. I'm worried about me. I'm worried about what y'all going to think about me. So I don't want to preach things to offend folk. But John said, I came here to offend somebody. I came here to upset somebody. I came here to make somebody say, I got to get out the way I'm living and change. We live in an age when preachers are about themselves. They got their own ministry. It's amazing. Everybody got their own ministry. So-and-so ministries. So-and-so ministries. And that's this day. But here's John. They asked John, who are you? John said, I'm a voice. Anybody ever seen a voice? He didn't even say, he said, I'm a voice crying in the wilderness. I ain't about being famous. I'm on a time clock, baby. Only got so much time to do it. You ought to slap your neighbor and say, you on a time clock too. You only got so much time to do what God has called you to do. We wrapped up in what we gonna do and who we gonna be. And listen, it ain't even about you. God has set an assignment. John said, y'all don't know why I came in. And then they tried to work John. You know, John's disciples in the text, you know, when Jesus started baptizing, they came to John and wanted to get something going on. You know, you got to watch folk. Folk ain't everybody that bring a tale, carry a tale. You watch people going to come tell you about what somebody said about you. That could be a setup. They trying to get you to act a fool. They trying to stir up and agitate you to get off your blessing. See, one thing about working for God, you got to maintain a clear focus. You can't let sidetrack and side conversations mess up your direction. See, some folk are sent by the devil or the flesh to mess up your direction. God is about to bless you. God is about to use you. God's about to anoint you, and they come and sidetrack you. Came to John, talking about John, that fella who was with you on the other side of Jordan. You know, they didn't even want to give John, they didn't know who John said, wait a minute, have y'all forgotten? John said, I saw him coming. And y'all call that fella on the side of Jordan. No, he was the Lamb of God who come to take away the sins of the world. John probably told him, listen, y'all don't know who y'all dealing with. Don't y'all remember when I baptized him? I asked him, I said, I'm not worthy. He said, look, suffer it to be so. John said, but I ain't even worthy to unloose your shoes. He said, suffer it to be so to fulfill all righteousness. Then he said, listen, John, go ahead and do it. And John said, well, don't y'all remember when I baptized him? God brought forth a mighty manifestation. He got in three places at the same time. My God, it was a dove coming down, a voice out of heaven. heaven, the sun in the water. Y'all missed that. It was God in three, it wasn't three gods. It was three manifestations of the one God, my God of heaven. He says, so y'all ain't got this thing right. See, when you're not self-centered, folk can bring you an accusation. It don't mess you up because you understand your assignment. I wasn't called to be great. He didn't save me to be famous. The Bible says you shall have power after the Holy Ghost has come to be a witness. That's my job, to witness, not to grow big and blow up. My job is to be a witness. Your job is to be a witness. You ought to be telling somebody about somebody that can save anybody. Not about you. John dealt with the text. They said, well, listen, and then they tried to play numbers game with John. They don't know who John was. John knew where he came from. John said, listen, y'all don't know my pedigree. Say, I was in my mother's womb in the Fallopian area, growing and becoming, and a word was spoken on the outside. And I was so in tune with the God of heaven that when I heard the word, I leaped with the Holy Ghost. My God, so see, as long as you leaping with the Holy Ghost, words can't bother you. Some of y'all in lost, y'all leap. Y'all let stuff bother you. Y'all sit up in church dead as a doorknob, and the word's going forth. You ought to be, when the word is going forth, you ought to feel something. My God, if you got, John, they told John, I said, listen, John, that Jesus, that fellow over there with his disciples, and they baptizing more than you. You know, John didn't say, wait a minute, who does he think he is? I'm the one baptized him. I'm his big cousin. No, John said, wait a minute. Y'all don't know the scriptures. The bridegroom is God. Israel is the bride. In our terminology, it's the church. The church belongs to Jesus. The church is supposed to glorify Jesus. If you don't ever call my name, I shouldn't get upset. If you don't ever say I preach, I shouldn't get upset. If you don't ever tell me I know how to sing, I shouldn't get upset, because you should be busy glorifying God. You should be so excited about the God who delivered you, the God who brought you out, that you ain't got time to praise nobody else. I'm too busy lifting up Jesus. But we in a sad day. You got to praise folk or they will leave your church. You got to tell them they're great. You got to tell them they're wonderful. You got to tell them, ain't nobody like you. Oh, please sing again. Oh, won't you come and preach for us? Oh, won't you teach? No. God say whosoever will. God ain't begging nobody. God say whosoever will. If you won't, I got a drunker. I got a dope dealer. I got a street walker. I got a regenerate. I got a homosexual. I'm coming here and straighten up and I live all y'all. I got a lesbian that'll come in here and get saved, and I'll live all of y'all. God ain't hard up for praise. We the one hard up. We want somebody to stroke us. We want somebody to lift us up. God said, loose here, you devil. You in my place. And ain't but one God. Get out the way. If you want to do anything, give me some glory. Because the Bible said, let everything that have breath. Glory, glory. It's not about us. John, they try to tell John, just listen, he's supposed to do what he's doing. My God, John, let him know it. This is Christ. This is Jesus. Y'all don't know what y'all dealing with. They tried to get John off track. Tried to mess John up. My God of heaven. John had an effective ministry. Oh, Lord, have mercy. People came to him. Even though he dressed funny. That's another thing. Help me. God, help me. I'm trying to get this thing right. Here is John. Didn't wear Hickey Freeman. Didn't wear gaiters. Didn't drive a Mercedes. Didn't get his hair done at the latest beauty salon or hairdresser. Didn't eat it at Michelangelo's or downtown at one of the restaurants. He ate wild honey and oak and locusts. He wore wool's clothes and looked right wild looking. But it ain't how he looked. It's what he represented. See, you ought to tell your neighbor, if I can get you to see Jesus, you'll stop focusing on me. See, John's ministry was so powerful because he made folk lose their focus off John and got wrapped up in the message. What we need to help people get the message. Forget about the messenger. Get the message. Forget about the one that brings it. Get the substance of the word. People came and drove to be baptized. If this was going on now, folk would come all over to John's ministry to find out, how do you build a mega church? Unless the Lord build the house. The labor, some of us are still dealing in mediocrity. We're still fumbling in the infancy of what we're trying to do because we haven't put God in it. We have put ourselves in it, and we think God is... What that y'all talk? God can't be fooled. We think we're going to build this thing up and then pull God in later on. God said, you got to be crazy. I want folk to know I started the thing. I built it up. And I'm going to, because the Bible says I'm the author and the finisher. God is at the beginning. God is in the middle. And God is at the end, baby. Oh, glory. Let me go on here. Move on in the text. John was dealing with some things. The scripture says, for thou shalt worship no other God. See, God does not want us caught up in false worship. Oh, God. We worship family, we worship friends, we worship ourselves. Some are so bad we can't get out of the house without looking in the mirror about 15 times. My God, don't you know as good as you look, somebody going to find a problem? Somebody going to see something out of order? That don't go with that. They look a mess today. And you spend all that time in front of the mirror. That's just human nature. God said, don't spend your time worshiping yourself. Be glad that I woke you up this morning. Be glad that you ain't sleeping the sleep of death. Be glad I still got a good mind. Be glad you still know how to clap your hands. Be glad you still can stump your feet, because there's a whole lot of folk can't clap their hands and can't stump their feet. There's a whole lot of folk can't open their mouth. There's a whole lot of folk can't stand up and glorify God. You ought to be glad God just gave. I'm going on. My God. He said, for thou shalt worship no other God, for the Lord whose name is jealous. He's a jealous God. God gets jealous when you start giving more glory to something other than him. You want to keep God in your presence? Keep bragging on him. Keep telling him how wonderful he is. Keep telling him how great he is. Keep telling him, can't nobody but nobody do me like Jesus. Keep telling him, if it had not been for the Lord on my side. Keep on talking, I can do all things through Christ that strengthened me. Keep on and bragging on God. God will anoint you with the oil of gladness. Come on, say yeah. The Bible says, I will say to the north, oh, give up. And to the south, keep not back. Bring thy sons afore, and thy daughters from the ends of the earth. Even everyone that is called by my name. For I've created them for my glory. I come to tell you, I was made for this. I was made to praise God. I wasn't made to be still. I wasn't made to sit up here and fold my hands and cross my legs. God made me to praise him. God made me to glorify my hand go up. My hand says to the rest of me, you got to be crazy. You better wake up, buddy. You better praise your God. You better give it to him. I was made to praise God. Oh Lord, oh Lord, help me, Lord. For thy name's sake, I will defer my anger. For my praise, I will refrain thee. I will cut thee not off. For the praise, God said, I won't cut you off. I was about to lose some stuff, but I praised my way back into my blessing. Y'all missed that. Some of us have lost some stuff because we didn't praise God. God said, I'm going to take it from you, but you praise me so, you worship me so, I had to bless you anyhow. I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. Say yes. Say yes. Glory to God. Glory. My own sake. Even my own sake will I do it.
For should my name be polluted, I will not give my glory to another. Slap your neighbor. Say, you my good friend, brother or sister, but I can't glorify you. You didn't bring me out. You didn't make a way. You didn't fill me with the Holy Ghost. You don't keep me late at night. You don't stop me from going crazy. You don't heal me when I'm sick. You don't cover my tears. You don't rest with me in the night season. I serve a God. It ain't about you. It's about him. I like you. You're a good person, but you ain't God either. I need one that's never sleep and never slumber. I need one that can answer every situation. I need one that'll show up right in time. Going to the close already. The Bible lets me know that God is God all by himself. He comes on the day to be glorified in his saints and be marveled in all who have believed. The saints are supposed to glorify him. If you a saint, you ought to stand up and give him glory. If you a saint now, you ought to stand up and give him glory. Oh, Lord, help me, Holy Ghost. Help me, Holy Ghost. You know, when I first got saved, it wasn't about me. I would give glory. They had to sit me down because it wasn't about me. I thought all I was supposed to do was praise God, praise God, praise God. They had to calm down, boy, calm down. Well, calming down has done something to us. Now we took the focus off God and we ain't got stuck on us. When I first got saved, I would praise God whether I felt like it or not because it wasn't about me. I was so glad to be in church. I was so glad to have the Holy Ghost. Now, I got a little time under my belt. Now I'm dealing with, I don't feel like it. It don't take all that. Oh, Lord. But I remember the former days when I used to praise God at the drop of a hat. He would show up and show out. Now I can't get a prayer through. It's because I've lost my praise. I've lost my worship. I got stuck on me. And it ain't even about me. I can't get myself out of nothing. As a matter of fact, I'm good at getting in trouble. I ain't by myself. We all good at getting in trouble. It's not in man to order him steps. And man is wicked. Man is evil. Man is lustful. Man is low down. Man is ungodly. Man is unsaved. I take the Holy Ghost to make me walk right. It takes the Holy Ghost to make me talk right. It takes the Holy Ghost to make me do right. It ain't about you. It's about God. It ain't about when I feel like it. The Bible said, let everything that have breath praise the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Say yeah. Say yeah. You ready to nail this thing down? A psychologist, Lord have mercy, and a theologist, theologian rather, had a debate. They were talking. The psychologist said, listen here, something's wrong with this Jesus y'all serving. He's an egotistic maniac. He's a lunatic. That's what the psychologist said. And the theologian said, what do you base that upon? He said, well, his own words. Jesus said, he that loveth his father or mother more than me is not worthy of me. He that loveth his son or daughter more than me is not worthy of me. Jesus said, he that taketh not his cross and follow after me is not worthy of me. Then Jesus said, he that findeth life, the same shall lose his life. And he that loseth his life for my sake shall find it. The psychologist said, that's lunacy. That's an egotistical maniac. Over 2,000 years ago, this man is telling folk that can't touch him, that can't see him, haven't been in his presence, to love him more than they love their parents, to love him more than they love their children, and then pick up a cross and die for him. He's got to be crazy. The theologian said, I think you missed it. You see, my mama can't do for me what Jesus done. My daddy can't do for me what Jesus done. Say yeah. Say yeah. talking. And he said in the old Bible days, in the Old Testament, they used to ask the question, when bad things happen, what did I do to deserve this? But we in another generation now, folks are saying when bad things happen, how dare God let that happen to me? Why is this happening to me? It's because, baby, you ain't all that anyway. Stuff happened to everybody. Slap somebody. Say, it happened to me too. Say, if you don't like what you got, let me give you what I'm going through. I got some stuff I like to give somebody. There's some stuff I like to get off me. I ain't by myself. Is there anybody wish they could take their trouble and put on somebody else? But God chose affliction to make us. He chose trouble to make us. Say it. Glory to God. I know what they're saying. Oh, Lord. The Bible says concerning God, this man said, well, he's got to be crazy. How can we put all our focus on him? Lord have mercy. Well, the theologian said, you should have kept reading your Bible. For the Bible said, I am the Lord and there's none else. There's no God beside me. I girded thee, though hast not known me. They may know from the rising of the sun in the east to the west that there's none else beside me. I am the Lord and there's none else. Not only that, but the reason when you talk about your stuff and the stuff you own and the stuff you acquired and the stuff you have gained, let me help you out. The Bible said the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof and all that dwell in it. It is God that giveth power to get wealth. Thank God for your education. Thank God for your job. Thank God for your position. Thank God for the stuff. But it belongs to God. Say yeah. Say yeah. Ain't God good? It ain't about you. It's about Jesus. That's the problem with church. We ain't lifting up Jesus. Somebody ought to praise him. It don't matter. When you come in the door, you ought to brought your praise with you. When you show up, you ought to have your shout with you. After all I've been through, I'm trying to figure sanctified folk out. Folk lose cars in church and out of church. Folk marriages break up in church and out of church. Loved ones die in church and out of church. So that ain't nothing new. But you ain't lost the power of the joy. That's why the songwriter said, you see, the world, when they lose, they got to go get a bottle. They got to go get some weed. They got to go get crack. They got to go do something strange. But when I lose, I go pick up my praise. I start remembering how good God is. Slap somebody. Tell them, after all I've been through, after all, shake their hand good. Let's let them know you've been through something. Let's let them know you had some trouble. Let's let them know you've been through some trials. Let's let them know you've been hurt. Let's let them know you had to cry sometimes. Let's let them know you've been mistreated. Let's let them know you've been misused. But after all I've been through, say yeah. Say yeah. They may be wondering how you still shouting, how you still dancing, because it ain't about me, baby. I praise God because he woke me up. I praise God because he started. I praise God because he never left me. Can't nobody do me like this. About you. Tell somebody I ought to be honest. Tell them, let me be honest. Say, I owe God more praises than I've given him. See, God blesses us in private, sometime for a public display, sure appear like we ain't had no trouble, ain't had no problems, everything been all right, I'm fine, and if you were like me, you... But some of us just struggled in here. We had to make it through the pain, through the hurt. It ain't been easy. Some of us been down so low that when I think of the good, when I think of... Tell some, I owe him a praise. He could have left me like I was, I owe him a praise. He could have left me in trouble, I owe him a praise. He could have left me confused, I owe him a praise. He could have left me by myself, I owe him a praise. I owe him a... We can mess this thing up. We ain't got stuck on stupid. Yes, we have. We think we control something. We ain't in control of nothing. Everybody hold your breath. Until I say let it out. See, you ain't in control. Some of you already said. If God don't send the next breath, if God don't release, I'm in here to serve God. I'm in here to worship God. I'm in here. I'm in a fight too, baby. You might as well be honest, you in a fight too. Your enemy, the devil, ain't playing. He trying to knock you out every chance he gets. He wants you to get stuck on you because he want to hurt your feelings. He want to get you upset so you leave the church. But I come to tell the devil, I ain't going nowhere. I wish, Jim, I ain't going nowhere. As good as God has been to me, devil, you got to be crazy. I'll stand here, I'll holler, I'll jump, I'll run, I'll scream. I'm going to do something, but I ain't going. Listen. God made the sun and the moon. Did you not know? The moon does not give off its own light. We looking at the moon tonight, or that shiny moon. The moon ain't nothing but a big rock. It reflects light off the sun. I'm looking at a lot of rocks. It ain't about y'all. If I take Jesus out of... Bible said in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same in the beginning with God. And all things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. Without Him was not anything made that was made. Without Him was not anything made that was made. So whatever you do, whatever you become, whoever you are, it was already made by Him. You just stepped into what He had already planned for. Whatever you become, it was already made by Him. Whatever you aspire to, it was already made by Him. And in Him was life, and the life was the light of men.